How's it going, everybody? Just getting set up here. Getting ready to do a little live streaming on YouTube. Gonna keep working on that predator drawing. If any of y'all saw it yesterday, it was what I was doing then. Gonna keep at it here. Just gonna take a couple seconds to get everything started up and throw out a little bit of a shout out on my Facebook page. Get that going. Maybe we can get a couple viewers in here tonight. So, get this guy going. Boom. Have that guy going there. And, oh yeah, one other thing. And let's post it. Cool. Boom. Got that guy posted. Got Photoshop opened up. Let's go in here. Get the character opened up. Funny story. So, I started this drawing. Initially, was not even going to be a predator drawing. It actually, let me see where it is here. Not even drawn the predator. It was sitting here, had a shaded screen. Was working on some silhouette ideas for just character designs, you know. Get out a little bit of creative processing, a lot of not having to think type drawing. That tends to cause me to stiffen up on figures, things like that. It's my analytical side kind of gets a little more involved. So, in case you guys weren't here last night and would like to know what I'm working with, other than, of course, what's in the title of Photoshop, I am working on a Wacom Cintiq 21UX. It's a older model, predates the days before they decide to go to a widescreen format, put all the touchscreen capabilities into that stuff. However, it still gets the job done. So, why get rid of something that's working for me, right? Last night I managed to get a bit of work done here on the shoulder cannon, which I'm gonna try and get finished up tonight. Didn't include it in the video, but went in here and started putting a bit of some cast shadow in. Trying to adjust for where it would go over and around certain contours, blocking more light, of course. A lot of this drawing would indicate that my light source, you know, is coming from, oops, coming from this direction here. Maybe slightly behind the predator. So I would think maybe some kind of like, oh, say this is my lighting source here. Lovely. So it's not quite straight on. It's not completely from the back. In fact, my lips would probably even still be tighter than that. A little more like that guy. Terrible drawing. Yeah, let's just keep noodling away here and see where things go. I started looking at some of the area in here where, even though I got some suggested stuff, I need to actually come and, oops, redo that guy. Get back to the black. Come in here, actually create an edge. More of a lip, and then help thicken up this line down here because this guy is right at the very bottom of the gun. Maybe catching a little bit of bounce light, which I can throw, you know, a couple small lines in here to accent that bounce lighting, still giving a bit of form. Where the gun get a little bit of cleanup. I see I can possibly do with my marquee lasso outlining here. Now that I'm zoomed in, let's clean up some of that stuff because I want everything to. You know, look good. A lot of other things I've been focusing on with this is just trying to speed up my drawing, man. Like, just as much as I love it, I'm not very fast with it. I tend to work a line more than I should. Can definitely be construed as being unconfident about some of my work, you know, like that concern that I'm just not appealing quite what I want to convey. Something like that, although, so I have this guy is creating this edge here. Bam. This piece here is creating an edge here. This up. up some of this blackness here. Too thick. Still too thick. And just so you guys know, the brush I'm working with is just a hard round with zero spacing on it. So that way I kind of get almost exactly what I get out of, say, a Micron or a hybrid. Where a Micron is a felt tip, water resistant ink. Those pens usually run around $4 to $5 a piece, maybe more. Hybrid is basically a couple pen companies decided to take a gel pen and put waterproof ink in it instead of your normal ink. And what that did was gave people a better consistency than what you get with either a ballpoint or some of the felt tip. And that allowed for just more even flow, steadier, stronger work capabilities. About this just don't feel quite right. I think I might go in and actually put some exposure there, because you're probably gonna have some of the blue plasma flash coming out of the cannon. You know, I don't want you don't ever want the exact point of action. You always want either the anticipation or the follow through with a lot of stuff. It builds for a stronger story visually. Those are just things that I learned about as far as with filmmaking, illustration especially. It tends to have more impact on the viewer. I don't know why. That'd be a good thing to know about, I guess. But if anybody happens to know why some of that stuff has more impact than the moment of, I guess. Is that what it would be? The moment of impact, or I think I need to break this area up a little more. You know, I find myself making many weird noises when I draw, so if it's off-putting, I'm sorry, but it's just the little kid in me still coming out and thinking about the action of the drawing. What's going on? In the story, I feel like this piece actually should be more like, kind of like that. Maybe come in here. Get rid of to some of that. Yeah, that looks way better, I think. Clean this up. Beauty of Photoshop. Nothing's ever set in stone. I mean, can you imagine the amount of slight redos that I've done in this drawing so far? Lines that I don't seem to throw and end up exactly as I expect them to. Know, I need to look something up. So I don't really want a chrome look, but I do want something like maybe just a yeah, I don't know. Something like that. I think a good majority of my drawings tend to be more happy accidents than anything. Like even if I don't find what I'm looking for, something might still actually turn out. Says my live stream's health. It's not doing so well. Check resolution. No way. You check my resolution. It was fine before. Why wouldn't it be now? Back to drawing. Don't feel like maybe if I get a good heavy. Not what I wanted. Well, know what I need to work on? How to make things look super metallic and shiny. Because definitely am not getting that appeal in my eyes. So, is anybody excited for the fact that there's going to be a new Predator movie coming out? No, pretty looking forward to that guy, actually. Especially because I heard rumors of a possibility that main character from the original Predator, Dutch, is supposed to make a reappearance in it. So, if that happens, I will be giddy as a kid in a candy store. Because Arnold is just sweet. Even though sometimes I don't always agree with his choice of movies that he's been in. Probably one of my favorite actors, just because it's Arnold, the Governator. What else do I want to do with this guy? Let's put some big old blotches of this and that all over this, the top of this gun. Then we'll come in and break some of it up. else I want to do for now, so I think I'm just gonna have to call that quits on this guy. Get down there. Know for a fact that I need to come in here and just be like, psh, so it's down just a bit now. Come in like that. Just gonna put an edge there. Put some small dings in. So that's what I got going on. Don't even have anybody watching me. No. No watchers. One of these days, maybe. For now, just trying to get my work done. Oops. Gonna break that edge up. Come in here and do some white feathering. This edge. This way, range. Load. You know, one of the problems I've had with choosing to be hunched over is I get a lot of nerve pinching going on in my neck, which is no fun because my hands go numb, my thumb most of all. It's kind of like a almost like a burning, icy sensation in it. And, it's not a very good feeling. Some of those things where it's like, really wish I didn't have to deal with it. And it even has many times slightly swayed me away from getting artwork done because of the pain that I'm actually experiencing from doing something I enjoy. I don't think it really matters whether I'm drawing hunched over at a desk or sitting at a table. Whatever it is, standing in an easel, still get the hands going numb. So it's just one of those things that I deal with. But yeah, I think we're gonna call that quits for the canon. And move on to something else. Now, one of the problems with me not committing to a full drawing is basically just trying to come up with stuff on the fly, which isn't good for production quality, but just doing my own thing. I don't see how it really hurts. However, that being said, I still end up spending a lot more time on something than I think I should. Let's see if I can come in here. Let's get back into this group. Start a new layer. Should I do for the arm? Give it some normal kind of arm appeal. You know, this pec be right in this area. Biceps start coming out here. So creating. Tension there. Feel like it's trapped. Might actually start coming down this way. So I got bicep there, tricep here. Deltoid like so. I don't think it really matters too much just because of the fact that a good majority of this guy will be in shadow here actually. I need to give it just a bit of a kind of a curve. Now, one thing I noticed with muscles. So when you start thinking in terms of the groups, especially in the shoulders, You have kind of three different major parts of the muscle that tend to bulge. You get this area here that comes across the top, and then you get one in the front, and then one across the back. And there is some connective tissue in between that kind of separates that out. So I'm gonna see if I can kind of create that here. Sorry, had a text I had to respond to. And want this a little thicker just because it's got the no, don't like those lines at all. Creating kind of that pinch. Don't know if I went quite high enough. Might need to actually follow up here. Get this pinch here, which probably needs to be broke up a little bit, just because. And then you get the separation. One thing that I learned from watching some of the great illustrators work in comics is they talk a lot about just more implication than anything. You know, you're better to have the underside edge of the shadow rather than, especially where muscles come together. So that's why I'm doing the bottom side of the deltoid and not implying the top edge of the bicep here, which there actually is this kind of wrapped connective tissue here. And then basically the backside of the deltoid here, not going to see a whole lot of. Because it should wrap a little more like this. Get a lot of that there. We'll have some separation here where the tricep comes out. Might actually break this guy up with a line like right there. Feels maybe a little too heavy, so come in and try and get something more like that. This here, though, actually definitely needs some, Either way, it don't really matter. Because then I'm going to come in here with this big guy and me before I get too out of control. Creating a lasso, and the reason why I'm doing this is because that way when I box in and I go like that, it kind of breaks up. And when I do that with the lasso too and create a selection, you don't get all this you don't get all this over. You can't draw past it. Sorry, losing train of thought here. Give them a little bit of splotchiness, because we know how these giant lizardmen alien dudes tend to look. Have some splotchy. Switch it up and just tap a couple areas with some white. Break up the patterns a little bit. So, like so, then I'll shrink back down here, start giving just some suggested lines of direction through this. mean, really, if we come basically from like this spot over, so if I, that is not what I want to do. Grab the selection tool here, hold down Alt. It'll allow me to go like this. Deselect that half. And I actually want to rethink that line just a little. There we go. Looks a little better there. Maybe come in here and be like, so kind of a little stretch in here like that, and throw another layer down since I just happen to have this selection good to go here. Switch like this and just go like. Bring the shadow down. We'll see. We'll see if I keep that. So I think I want to come down here, switch over to white, go like this, and then come in and be like, be like, yo, man, keep that selection going. So I can come in here and give some suggested line as well with the white, kind of like I did with the hair almost. Just some contour line to break up a lot of this heavy blacks, blotted, and kind of, you know, because I don't know, all this shit's gonna be. All of this stuff is going to catch light, and the way the direction of the light's coming, basically it should be from good majority of this stuff in here should be in color anyways. So, or I mean in shadow, basically you would come down, start to create shadow that drapes even more so. But we'll work on that. Let's create a new layer, and we're going to come in here now. Switch to black. Right. Pinch point. Pinch point. There should be like line here. Oops. Line here. And then line. This way. Another line. all this other stuff. For what? Now I can select this stuff here. Be like, hey. I don't know if that's big enough. I don't feel like it is. Might actually have to see if I can take this. And what I'm going to do is yeah, that's not creepy, Mike. Okay, what I was going to do is go to my select and grow and grow some more, grow some more. So I realized I didn't make my lines quite as big as I wanted them to be. So we'll see. I still don't know if I expanded my pixels quite enough. Might need to do a little more. Modify, expand. There we go. Expand by, let's say, 2 pixels. Maybe one more time. Expand by 2 more pixels. Yeah, there we go. Now that's what I'm talking about. So I can go in here, just recolor these guys like this. And then I make sure I'm on my pins. Command start giving these pieces some, oops. Let's turn the shadow off for a sec. Give these guys some highlight here. Too big. Bad line. And let's break up the black a little bit. And now I got some rope that doesn't really stand out too well. So I'm gonna come back in here, add back in a little more black, break up some of this white. Oh, hush, dog. I may have to take a break here for a second. Go let my dog out. And one thing that I'm kind of trying to do is create pinch points too, where you may see, I feel like you almost can't even see this stuff, but it's there. Let me get rid of this selection. I'll come in. Add just a little, oops. A little white to the white side of the threading. We got too much other stuff going on. Take this down. Nope, can't do that. Gotta leave that as plain Jane as possible. Definitely need to come in here though. Probably redo this selection here just to make things easy. Then come in, get rid of a lot of this. So I want my threads to stand out, you know what I'm saying? So I'd rather reduce other things So that way they're more prominent. So once I create this bit of breakup here, we'll go in and be like, oh yeah, can't have this quite so solid. So add a little bit of some. I don't know why I'm getting so technical. Shit's gonna be in mostly in daylight or in nighttime anyways. But I can take this selection here. Create just a slightly oops. That does not work, James. Should know better than that. In here, does it not really feel quite the way I want it to? Well, since it's my drawing, I imagine it's probably me not getting it to feel quite the way I want it to. Because this guy here should be like, and this guy over here should even be like, and this guy here is just completely in the black, arm included. Even though there would be a bit of a suggestion that it's there. This here needs to go. Needs to reflect that there. I don't know what anybody thinks. Nobody will talk to me. Careful. Oh, there you are. I need to get a Cintiq or equivalent soon. What's up, dude? I think while I'm at it, I'm just going to go with this. Start creating the idea that this here. I think that's how I want to do it. Come on. Hey, thanks, man. I know it's not quite. I can't get it to appear quite the way I want it on the arm. I think I got a little too much just contour line going on there, but most of that stuff's going to be in shadow anyway, so I don't think you'll even see it. But what I'm working on here is I took my selection tool and kind of spaced out an area where I'm just going to take and fill that sucker in right there. Bring that opacity down just a little bit, maybe right around that area. And go from there with that. Take that away, get the eraser out here. Create that illusion. And then I'm coming here with just normal blacks like this on the lowered opacity. Start working on a little more detailed area. Get a really nice curve like that. Light is wrapping around those points. Yeah, I don't know why I'm putting so much work into putting quite so much work into some of the detail when 90% of it's going to be blacked out almost with shadow, because another piece of shadow I need to start contemplating would be this piece here, which will be like, basically will come this way, swoop around. Come down here, catch right about there, come down here, around the eye, past the tusks on the mask, down that side. These tusks will even be in shadow. This part of the face, all in shadow. One of the parts, though, that I have to make sure and exclude from the shadow will be the eyes. Bring that guy down right around there. So I want the skull to stand out most of all. Or not the skull, but the mask. I think that should be good there. Clean it up a little bit. So yeah, Cintiq is definitely worth the money you pay for it. I don't know about the whole new Dell thing you're talking about, but I'm sure it's pretty nice. I mean, I don't know how on the ball it'll be as far as comparability. To a Cintiq, since they basically are the ones that really started implementing pressure sensitive drawing techniques into digital art. And I've seen a ton of really nice work come off a shoot, just the pens that they offer on a surface, like what Nate has. Kind of clean this line up just a little bit more. And I mean, a lot of this still will even be in shadow, but basically it'll be in the shadow completely with it coming back and behind him. I'll say it's up a little high, almost like moonlighting. However, like I said, one thing that will not be in shadow right here, because they are a light source, is the eyes. So, clear this out. Maybe bring that opacity up just a little more. And I think that's going to be about it for the Predator himself. I mean, some other small details, but nothing too much. I grab the gun, group it for itself. So I come down to this guy, and I need to erase unnecessary sketch lines. Make it new. Since it's the background, let's put it in the background. Oops. Right. Whoa. Okay, maybe I forgot one detail. We need to have a fill-in for the Predator. Son of a gun. There we go. Now I can paint behind him, and it won't be a problem. Although I will need to think about, let's see here. Oops. Deselecting first, then coming in and bam. That is a horribly, horribly done. Oops. There's a passing. Just so I can kind of see what I need to do. Turn those opacity back down. Switch to that layer. So as badly as I wanted that layer to be there, it's not gonna happen. Let's take it back to the top. Taking it from the top. Let's start with this tree here. Oh, it's like, why am I not drawn? Because you're on the eraser, you buffoon. That is not what I want to do. What I want to do is create some random kind of like. Thank you. Good old drawn trees. Randomness. Anybody got anything they want to say out there? All none of my viewers. You know, one thing that's always a good idea too is to sit and actually commit to saving your work every once in a while. Because I'll tell you what sucks, losing all of it. That's new layer. I'm actually gonna size this down while I work on the tree because those details are not quite as important. I mean, all details are important, right? Me come in here and get some really nice heavy. down here to about a. Oops. Heck with it. Let's get up here. Put that guy at about a 30, 29, 30, somewhere on there. Core shadow.
Oh.
Coming in right like this. Actually, while I'm thinking about it, let's start putting this shadow into. I need to get in here and actually come in. Oops. Sum up again. Now I can come in there. suppose you need to go outside, my dog. So what you want to go outside. All right. Well, didn't realize I've actually been on here for about an hour and 45 minutes almost, and I think I'm going to have to call that quits for the night. I don't really want to have to stop where I'm at because I'm kind of in the zone, but unfortunately I have an animal that needs his needs taken care of, a little food, maybe go outside, whatever he needs to do. So thanks for stopping by and watching this, if you watched it at all. I hope you like what you see, you know, that you hit the share button or the like button if you're interested, as well as if you'd like to subscribe to my channel. I'm going to start trying to do live chat actually 3 to 4 times a week. Try and actually get a little bit more of a midday range, just so that way catching people more during the daytime rather than this late at night. Like I said, thanks again for stopping by, and till next time. Take care.